They stole all her money twice.
This is a story about the first American cookbook written by a Black person, that we know of at least. This book is 155 years old this year and has tasty recipes you'll recognize as classics. There are also a few weird recipes that'll make you laugh. The writer, Malinda Russell, has a powerful story. She's someone you should know about. Let me tell you about her and about her food. Welcome to Family Meal, where we're all about memory-making meals with a splash of wine. It's a virtual brunch. This story is the first installment of 2021, y'all, and it marks a milestone, the oldest book we've ever discussed on Family Meal. Let's get into it. It's 1866, just 1 year after the 13th Amendment abolishing slavery is ratified, and 15 years before renowned Black pickle entrepreneur Abby Fisher will write her cookbook in San Francisco. Malinda is writing her cookbook. Most of the recipes are for sweets. There are 70 recipes for cakes and lots of other dessert recipes. She's writing in Pawpaw, Michigan, a farming village of a few thousand people, but she's from Tennessee. She's writing from up there because holding anti-slavery views in the South can get you robbed, or worse. She was spared the worst down there, but she did get robbed. They stole all her money twice. The first time, she was 19 and was traveling to Liberia. She planned to live there, but one of the other travelers stole her money. She never made it past Virginia. The robbery ended her travels for about a decade. She settled near Lynchburg and worked as a cook and as a nurse. After Virginia, she goes back home and runs a boarding house and then a pastry shop. The shop is where she perfected all those cake recipes. But she's a single Black woman baking during the Civil War. In other words, she's a target. That's why on January 16, 1864, a Confederate guerrilla band attacked Malinda and stole her savings. Meanwhile, in Michigan, Sojourner Truth, the anti-slavery and women's activist, is living in Battle Creek, just 40 miles away from Pawpaw. There's a network of people in Southwest Michigan who are connected to the anti-slavery cause, and networks of safe houses and churches are nearby if needed. In Pawpaw, there's community and a chance for peace. So she moves to peaceful Pawpaw and begins at 54 years old to write this cookbook that will become a treasure. And she writes about the classics of African-American cuisine: peach cobbler, green tomato preserves, blackberry spirits, sweet potato pie, chow chow, baked salsa pie, plus a lifetime's worth of cake recipes. That's what Malinda Russell is serving up. Anybody that can do that with food is someone worth learning about. But don't take my word for it. Make these recipes yourself. Watch this playlist with all of the recipes and wines inspired by her cookbook. Or check out Malinda's whole story on the blog. It's a riveting tale. The link is below or click right here.